When we were in Jan, I think we had a very, I mean, that's when we are doing our AOP for this year, and the kind of targets that we have set ourselves. I mean, we set ourselves a target of doing 1 million transactions per day anytime during this year. And that is kind of aggression that we were going in this Jan of this year. From Jan to Feb, we grew again 30% on our transaction. That's kind of growth that we have seen. And where, because there's a lot of initiatives that we were planning for March, April, May. And in Feb, I think end of Feb, Feb went really well in terms of transactions. We touched around half a million transactions, 5 lakh transactions per day. But obviously, suddenly, as not planned, March 3rd week or on 20th or something, you realize that the entire country is going to lockdown. So, because we are spread over multiple cities, and having multiple teams, it's not only a technology and engineering and product team. We also have operations, call centers, etc. And then suddenly we need to plan on how do you enable work from home for call center people? How do you enable onboarding teams on a remote basis? And the major impact that we have seen is yes, business continuity is important, but there are more than 250,000 captains, 2.5 lakh captains that are active with us. And suddenly, if it went to lockdown, that means the earnings are going to get impacted of these people. So, what should we do? We started a captain fund to make sure at least a few top captains who are completely reliant on Rapido to make daily income. So, at least we fulfill their daily essentials. So with that fund, with the help of with our team members, founders, and also customers, you can raise a fund for captains. Maybe it will be sufficient for a week or 10 days, but not more than that. I mean, you have 250,000 captains, right? So how do you ensure that business continuity in terms of revenue and then the driver income? And that's where we brainstormed and came with a couple of ideas and a couple of focus points for the company in the next 5 6 months. And that's where we started focusing on logistics as a sector. We started partnering with, apart from BBMP and Delhi government, we started partnering with BigBasket, Big Bazaar, Spencer's, Swiggy, Zomato, and ensuring that home delivery for all these categories exist. In the 2 weeks of May, then we came up with two new products. One is our Rapido Local, which is ensuring peer-to-peer logistics. By June, we expanded to all the 100 cities that we are our Rapido Local solution. And B2B, we expanded to almost 35 cities, like all these partnerships that we have got, which is food and grocery delivery. We launched our store app a month back in June, mid of June. And we just launched in Bangalore and then we expanded to one tier two city. So we are still in that understanding in terms of what else can we build. But again, the thought process is going from an aggregator to individual stores and enable home delivery to every small scale business in the country. Logistics used to be 10% of the business, but if you see the revised our plan that we had for this year, right now we are saying that 30% of the business will come from logistics. 90%, 92% used to be our bike taxi business, and 8% used to be our logistics business pre-COVID. Because we are spread over multiple cities and different use cases. As I said, the use case has changed, but people coming out and non-existent of public transportation is a new business opportunity completely. So I don't see a challenge at all where we maintaining a 70% people transportation because there are enough number of people coming out. Pre-COVID, 300 million people used to, 300 million commutes used to happen on public transportation or intermediate public transportation. And now suddenly public transportation is stopped. I mean, imagine in a city like obviously like Delhi, where your metro is completely stopped, and then there are 3 million transactions used to happen every day. I mean, suddenly, where are they? Even though the 10% of the people are coming out, where are these guys traveling, right? So, in that way, I see our again taxi business growing in a similar way or coming back, and then maintaining 70% in the overall business. I don't see it as a challenge. after this local has come up, so there has been one other use case where if you're not going to office, so how do you send or receive items? So earlier, our people transportation used to be very high weekday and peak in the morning and the evening types. But after this local coming up and store and logistics coming up, we have seen definitely a spike in the weekend, as in Saturday and Sunday, where the logistics as a use case is much more prominent. The user base has changed right now. Earlier, youngsters from 18 to 22 age group, which are majorly college students and engineering, plus one, plus two people. So that used to be our 25 to 30% of the business, but now it's all of a sudden, it's like less than 10%. Your majority of the people who are coming out is the government employees who are coming out, or the obviously people working at hospitals, people who are working as in where government employees. So the age group has completely shifted from 18 to 22 to 25 to 35 now is the major huge age group, which was not there earlier. And our average distance has drastically gone up. Earlier, people were using us for last mile, 3-4 kilometers as a use case, but suddenly because your public transportation doesn't exist, now our average distance have increased almost by 35% in some cities. So now, and then overall level, it increased by 25%. So the average distance, that means the use case has completely changed. Now people are using it, almost 100% are using from home to work than using it for just last mile kind of use case. So earlier we used to have different teams for different initiatives, but now completely new initiatives have come in. So now we picked the people from different teams and formed one we called as virtual team for every initiative. And then we try to build that product within 15 days. So a lot of coordination, because whiteboarding has to be done maybe through talking or maybe a completely new tools which you have never used, etc. So there is a lot of learning curve that they have gone through. Obviously, the first product, the challenges are a lot more, but the second and third and fourth product that we have launched within 2-3 months, like it went like super, super quick. And especially a B2B integration that we are talking about earlier, right from our B2B team, right from getting a client to signing a contract to integrating the technology and then testing it and then launching it, used to be a 1 month to 45 days process. And within 2 weeks, we onboarded more than 10 merchants, right? So that kind of pace that the maybe pandemic has gave us, and definitely it's a huge, great learning, and definitely it's exciting. It looks like how we used to do things when we started our company, where things are just moving fast. We haven't taken any major steps in terms of people or anything. You have done a lot of optimizations, a lot of offices are gone through, a lot of negotiations have gone through, a lot of softwares have changed just to save cost. A lot of Google Cloud is like the cloud cost, we have made sure that we optimize with the help of obviously Google and also a lot of other client, a lot of internal team that we have built. We got down the cost by almost 1/3. So there is a lot of things that has run through to make sure that we don't take any extreme steps. FY20 to FY21, we were planning to grow 3 times. Maybe we'll grow 1.5 times. We'll still grow. I mean, I think we will be the only mobility company. We will grow at FY21 compared to FY20. If you take June and July, our net revenue, we have recovered almost 35 to 40%. And we know vehicle ownership in India is less. Hardly 18 to 20% of the people own the vehicle, and still there are 80% of the people who can't own, who are not owning the vehicle, and it will take some more time, even though during this time, because there's a financial impact also, I don't see people owning the vehicle just within a month or so. So that as an opportunity has come. And then overall, I will definitely say, because bike taxi has some advantages, because of which maybe our recovery rate is much larger, much higher than any other sector, just because one, the price point is more attractive to public transportation users.